Hello everybody, welcome to another edition of the Dashawns2cents. The new and approved the Dashawns2cents. We're better, bigger than ever. I was on location all weekend. From Fountain Valley to Reseda to Monrovia, I saw four shows. Santino's Thursday, Friday Mach 1, Saturday Person Gorilla, and Sunday, Quintessential Pro. Awesome shows. And coming up on this episode, we'll have interviews with Hudson Envy, Brian Cage, Rick Knox, and also thoughts from Drake Younger, Chuck Taylor, The Chef, and more. A lot of great stuff on this episode, and even my sister will rant about WWE. So we got stuff edited now. This is, I'm doing my little opening video thing, what I can do. So I'm excited for the future of Dashawns2cents. And let's enjoy the rest of the show, people. Have fun. John Davis did everybody.
He murdered us. Yeah, it's a piece of crap. I hate it. Hope he dies.
It was too bad about a ball. 0-3. We got a new Chuck Taylor here, ready and go.
I'm ready, man. Ready tonight for Roderick Strong and Eddie Edwards. It's going down.
They're gonna chop hard. You ready for it?
I'm gonna wear a t-shirt. I'm okay.
You're wearing a t-shirt. We got two colors of the shirt.
I'm gonna wear four t-shirts.
Four t-shirts.
Yeah.
How much are these shirts? Where can we get them?
$20.
$20.
That's guy all good. Four.
And we also got these 8x10s. Put these on there. That's pretty cool. So anything else you want to say to the fans of the Dashawns2cents?
No, I got nothing.
Thanks
for supporting. Just keep coming out. Keep coming to shows.
Hey, what's up? Jay here, pre-show, getting my drink on, getting ready for 60 minutes. It's gonna be the shit. This guy is the man.
Yeah, this man gets loud. He gets live. I love it. Yeah, I love it. Yeah.
What do you think, match? Based on the steam, what do you think?
Big match. Ever since I came here, that's the match people wanted to see. When the people talk, PWG listens, and so they're getting it tonight, man.
Tell people about a gorilla and why you should watch Gorilla.
My God. Words can't describe it. The atmosphere alone. It's pre-show right now. You can feel the energy vibing. You can feel it getting loud live right now. And by the time the bell rings, the roof will literally be ready to explode.
And what
from
merchandise
all the
you got here? Let's see the merchandise.
Got my shirts here. Got my shirts, got my coffee, and I got my smile. That's the merch.
Always
I got.
A smile. Yeah, always a smile here.
Alright.
Welcome back. I'm here with Brian Cage, the fucking machine right here. How you doing, man?
Good, man.
Intermission. How you like the show, man?
The show's been going good, man. I wish it would have started
earlier. Sorry, 9 o'clock, people.
Like 9:45. I was the first match. I think I know.
How was the wrestling with Johnny Yuma during your time? I know you've wrestled before.
I've been there with him once or twice. It was fine, easy day at the office for myself and Michael Elgin.
Your 3-day weekend at Evolve. How was that wrestling after
the over at Evolve, man. Florida was great.
Hold on, man. Hold on.
Awesome. Hold on, buddy. Hold on.
Yeah, sorry.
It was awesome. I don't know. We got Chuck Taylor, the Young Bucks, and John Davis.
Yeah.
I think the Davis match was the match that people were looking forward to the most. Actually, that's the match that tore my tricep in.
Oh, damn, man.
The buckle bombing in the corner. But the Young Buck match was probably my favorite.
You guys got the win. How is it working with Anthony? He's a great athlete.
Tony Nese is phenomenal.
Anthony, or he'll get mad at us. Anthony Nese.
I'm going to push for him to get out here, man. I'd love to do some stuff with him. Or like,
PWG needs to book him. He's fucking amazing.
I would love to do more stuff with him team-wise and opponent-wise. He's, like I said, he's built. He can do it all. He's an athlete. He's taller, so he's great, man.
My dream match was you guys to verse each other. I was tweeting that shit.
It'd be great. So I almost had it happen to Bushido. He almost got booked at the end of the month against me, but it fell through. So
what's with the red hair, man? You got the dying hair.
You know, I was over when I was over in Florida. I have family friends, and one's a hairstylist. She always offers to do stuff to my hair, you know, for free. I was like, oh, you know what? I matched my red here. Let's put some red in there. What the heck? A little change up. So just figured I'd do something new.
I was having the girls as your valets, Buggy Nova and Trina Michaels.
Well, you know, the ladies always come around Brian Cage and call them an effing machine, right? They want to get their shit in, but no, it's fine, no big deal. I don't trip on that stuff. It is what it is.
People give people like one workout tip to get like this. I know you can't get this in one day, but
that's the biggest tip. You can't get like this in one day. Everybody wants it now.
Give a person a simple tip that they can do.
I mean, consistency is the key. That means diet, training, supplements, all 9 yards. It ain't gonna happen overnight. It's not just one trick pony. It isn't just diet. It isn't just eating. It isn't just a certain workout or any of that. It's everything all meshed together and doing it over and over and over and over again.
Ain't you ever seen Hollywood or NWE again?
NWE, yes. No, Hollywood.
I've heard rumors. I don't want to start anything up. I talked to Mark Casey. Said you would love to have you back, but I just know anything about it.
It's, you know, my schedule's pretty busy, and it's hard to fit that one in. NWE, I keep on getting booked for too, but just other dates happen. Like he actually pulled me off the show to work this. Show up north against Christopher Daniels next weekend because he wanted
it. Versus Christopher Daniels? That's going to be awesome.
Next week I'm going to work with Christopher Daniels.
Oh, where would it be?
It's in Turlock, California for Fighting Spirit Pro.
Oh, that's right.
And MWE, the commissioner, pulled me off that because he knew that match would be a better match. So I'd like to see that match. I'd rather you work him. They come down here.
Break it down. What about the Fighting Spirit Pro Lucha thing that last Sunday? There was some stuff that happened. Anything update on that?
New York? Oh my gosh.
Yeah, anything you can say about that?
You know what? I don't even want to give them any sort of positive or negative.
I heard like terrible experience for all those people there.
It was bad. It was the worst experience I've ever had. So it was a nightmare.
Where can people see what coming events?
We got QPW tomorrow for the title tournament in Monrovia. And then Turlock, California next weekend for Fighting Spirit Pro. Then Pro Wrestling Machino in Stockton, California, June 30th. And then what? I think that's really it until the California Cup in Fresno, California, which is a pretty sweet tournament. I'm against Johnny Gargano in the first round.
That's awesome. He's going to cover it. That's pretty cool. Yeah. Anything to plug? Like, anything you got full here?
You can follow me on Twitter, Mr. Gmas IB Cage. Facebook/Brian Cage on Facebook. That's pretty much it.
Any dream opponents you got? Anybody you want to call out?
I would love, but I try to make it happen to work Samurai Del Sol.
Oh, yeah, but he's leaving soon.
Gone, and it just wasn't going to happen. So, you know, he's up there. He'd be up there. Ricochet as well. Get to work Ricochet to see this match.
Yeah.
I'd love to have Ricochet one-on-one. Outside of that, I mean, there's obviously a handful of talents, but those are top two guys. And so, we'll see what's going on. Maybe a rematch with the Young Bucks as well, because I think Galvin and I should have.
Yeah, you only held the titles for intermission.
Yeah. You know, we should have won the whole thing.
It was a dominant reign. Yeah, hell, that was dominant reign.
So I think maybe them as well, because I think we should be champs.
Yeah, check out all the interviews, and thank you for being on the show, man.
No problem, man.
So make sure to like this video. Peace. Senior referee, Rick Knox.
Thanks for having me. My pleasure.
How many promotions are you senior official at?
I don't know. At this point, I guess, there's PWG and Hollywood and AWS. I suppose those are like the three. I am here, Quintessential Pro. I guess they do consider me the senior ref here, so that's probably maybe four.
We just finished an awesome weekend. What was your summer highlights? You remember the 1 hour armor match? How was that?
It was phenomenal. It was really a great match. You would think that for a couple of guys who are going to go 60 minutes that they're going to.
Adam Cole counter armor match.
Yeah, this was Adam Cole and Sami Callihan. Sami Callihan's last match before going off to WWE, so it was a little bit special there as well. But they're both phenomenal athletes, and these guys deserve all the accolades that they get because they held everyone's attention for the full 60 minutes.
It didn't feel like 60 minutes.
It really didn't. I remember thinking during the match maybe the first 10 minutes was like, oh, wow, this is going to drag. But then after that, it just kind of flew. In fact, I think towards the end, we kind of ran out of a little bit of time there, actually. But it was a fantastic show. And, I was definitely feeling it this morning, so I can imagine how those two guys were feeling today.
Adam Cole's walked back. He did look good. He looks still good.
Still... Those dudes are awesome. I mean, the shape that they're in, it...
The third match from the card was awesome. What match stood out to you that you saw?
Well, another one that really stood out to me would have been the tag match right before the main event.
Oh, yeah.
Samurai and AR Fox against the Young Bucks. I got to watch most of that from the back. And
how awesome is AR Fox? He can do things that I don't think anybody else can do.
Yeah, it's phenomenal. And another guy, I mean, Samurai Del Sol, this was also his last match.
He's leaving to the...
He's going off to WWE, and he got a great send-off, and... Sin Cara better watch for his job. That's
yeah,
all
keep the mask on.
Yeah, I'm sure they will.
So like, maybe I'm at home so I can talk to you for a little bit now. So, you, how many years have you been wrestling now? You're certainly Godfather now, all wrestling.
Well, I started in, I believe it was 96 is when I first started doing my training. So, it's been a long time.
Yeah.
I'm definitely showing my age. I was kind of laughing in the ring tonight. Joey Ryan said something to me like, you know, do I need to teach you the rules? I'm like, Joey, I've been doing this a lot longer than you have. I remember when Joey first came into the School of Hard Knocks as a kid.
As a golf, he had a golf.
Yeah, I remember that too. And it's been a quite a ride. I mean, a lot of ups and downs, a lot of different promotions that I've worked for. Some great, some not so great, but I don't have any regrets really.
This is a rapid question. What's the worst match you've ever wrestled? Like, worst match, like...
In all reality, probably, and I honestly don't know who it was because there were a couple of
students. Yeah, that's about
it. We did a show, it was for, I want to say it might have been the International Wrestling Council, which would have been around 2000-2001. They threw a couple students out into this pre-show match, and these kids were not ready to be in the ring. And basically, I took it home early, I counted them three when they weren't down, and the crowd cheered and was appreciative of the fact that I ended the match for these poor kids, and yeah, unfortunately, I don't know who it was. These guys might still be wrestling today, it might be someone prominent, and I wouldn't even remember because it was that forgettable.
But even on PWG, the mismatch, you probably got on PWG, you wrestled, how many matches you wrestled? You've been there longer than Joey, longer than most people.
Yeah, I mean, if you think about it, I mean, I've been there since the first show. I maybe have missed one or two PWG shows, and they were usually night one or night two of a doubleheader.
Yeah.
Other than that, I mean, I've been there since the beginning, so yeah, I definitely have more tenure there than anybody.
Well, wrestling last September, Battle of LA, teaming with Generico and Steen, how was that, man?
That was a definite highlight, definite highlight.
You can get the clothesline going, you can go to the top, probably use some moves, man.
Well, in all reality, that was like my third match that I wrestled. First match that I wrestled was against a guy named Dick Danger back in 2000, and we did a lot of silly
Dick
stuff.
Dick Danger? Yeah. That's a victory.
Dick Danger's a name going back to the late 90s, early 2000s. And then my second match was against Johnny Paradise at AWS. Okay. That would have been maybe 2007, 2008, can't quite remember. And that was a hard match. I remember thinking I was going to die afterwards. And then we did the six-man, which was just a lot of fun. And I don't think the situation with the Young Bucks is actually over yet.
Oh, yeah, they're always trying to super people.
Yeah, I mean,
Angela, Horton.
And even we've had incidents in the last show here. We had an incident at the King of Flight tournament. I mean, there's a lot of history between
the Young Bucks. They knocked you out at Austin,
yeah, yeah.
450.
Yeah, 450, that's right. That was another one. I mean,
you didn't remember most of the show.
You can probably do a highlight video of every time they kicked me and hit me or
there
something.
Is a highlight video of Knox, you're like a beast. That's when there's a highlight video on YouTube.
Wow.
There's
that's funny.
Name some highlights you've had in your career. It's been a long career. Name some quick things come to mind.
I would say another. I remember the first hour long match I did. Let's see, was it the first one? I think so.
Yeah.
It was AJ Styles and Chris Daniels.
Oh, yeah.
It was a 60 minute draw. Yeah. Neither one of those guys had ever wrestled a full 60 minute match before, so that was their first time as well. And so that one stands out. My NWA title matches where a new champion was crowned were highlights. I can literally probably rattle off a list of PWG highlights alone. Working for WWE's Christian's Lawyer was an
highlight. Oh yeah, Christian's Lawyer, remember, I saw that.
Yeah, that was really fun, and it was supposed to turn into a longer thing. And as things happen with WWE, things get rewritten, and next thing you know, I was no longer in the storyline, but that's the way it goes sometimes. But it was definitely a fun experience. I wouldn't change it for the world.
So, you like where you are now? You're the top guy, but he looks up to you, Jason, Justin, all the good referees around here, Jason, I don't have to.
Yeah, I mean, we're we're a pretty close little group here as far as...
There's not many referees here in SoCal. There's like probably like five or six.
Yeah,
there's
maybe six or seven of us who are considered the core group, and we all bring something a little different, I think, to the table, which is kind of unique. We're a mixed group, which is very cool. But
maybe
that
you're the taker of referees.
Yeah,
sure. So you're like at the core, buddy.
That's right.
So if something's wrong, you're going to get him.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, and a lot of times, promoters will look at me to talk to the referees about stuff. But, you know, overall, we appreciate each other's input. I mean, I've probably been doing it longer than everyone, but I'm still learning stuff every day. It's just kind of the way
Next
it is.
Weekend, are you reffing the Sabu T.J. Perkins match?
Yes, as far as I know, I am, yeah.
Have you reffed Sabu before?
I've worked with Sabu a couple of times before.
I'm pretty sure you're familiar with T.J.
Yeah, I mean, I gotta admit, we're a little concerned. It is a very much a clash of styles.
Has T.J.P. ever been in this type of match?
Well, I don't really think he has, and I don't think he wants it to go that route as far as a traditional Sabu match.
No tables, no hard work.
Yeah, I mean, it's not what TJ's thing is, and my suggestion to TJ as we talked today about it was make Sabu work, make him wrestle, you know? I mean, and if you make him wrestle, I think Sabu will accordingly react, and I think we're going to have a great match between the two, and I think it's going to be something a little different than what most fans expect and are used to seeing from Sabu and TJ, but I don't expect a lot of craziness as far as tables and chairs and barbed wire, but I expect a lot of good wrestling in that match.
So
we're going to be surprised.
ABS next Sunday would be pretty cool. Yep. You got your referee shirt. How's that? You got doing?
Yeah, it's doing okay. I haven't brought them to the last few shows just because the merch table hasn't really been very accommodating for it, so I haven't really brought it out. A few people are sporting them, which is kind of nice to see.
They gave you like the sixth time we tried to get this one together, but finally it's like...
We've been trying for a few months now to hook this up.
So yeah, so it's great to finally get it together.
Absolutely.
We edited everything now, and it's good to have you on the show, man. Thank you for being on.
My pleasure. Yeah. We'll do it again, and maybe we can sit down and relax.
Yeah, definitely. In studio, you're always open. In studio, always open.
We'll take you up on it. Thanks very much.
Chase,
thanks, guys.
Hudson, Andy, how you doing? Good. Just had a good match with him. That not one. Okay, Katana, where was that?
Easy.
Easy.
Again, Southern California girls.
You're just rolling through.
I am. There's not one that I haven't beaten.
How many times did you beat Tab Jackson? I looked on your stats. This is like five times.
Yeah, about 5-7 times. Yeah.
So your suspension's up for AWS. We'll be back. Jersey, Priest, and Candice Ray, and Crystal something?
Crystal White.
Crystal White. I haven't seen her wrestle, has she?
I haven't.
Yeah, I've seen her wrestle.
I don't know.
How'd you get in the wrestling?
Actually, I've always watched it because I was a little kid. And I was just like, that's what I wanted to do.
So you trained at EWF?
I do. I
trained
with Jesse Hernandez.
That's pretty good. How's he as a trainer?
Amazing.
He's on the show. He's a great guy.
Yeah. I've been trained by Leilani Kai. So, have that blessing.
So you're top women right now, and how do you like to wrestle here in SoCal? I know there's not many women to wrestle here.
There isn't many women to wrestle here, but I can tell you that every time I step in the ring with them, it's something new. They do throw something different at me, so it still keeps me on my toes. But there is a Utah wrestler I have beef with.
Oh, yeah. I saw the promo. I saw Vendetta Pro Summer Sizzle promo.
Even though I didn't beat her.
Oh.
Lacey Ryan.
Oh, yes.
Lacey Ryan. We have unfinished business. You think she can come onto my territory and show off? Ain't happening.
And the rest of the Vendetta Pro has not been.
I love it.
They fill it up, what, 2,000 people? Santa Maria?
Yeah, it's packed. Definitely.
The fans can really get into it and all that. What do you about the people that take women's wrestling negatively and always think it would be a bad match, a bathroom break, all that?
You know, I used to get offended by that, but then as I started wrestling, people actually give me compliments of like when I have matches with Candice LeRae.
Yeah.
They will say, you know, we don't get up and get popcorn, we actually sit down and watch a match. And same thing with Tab Jackson. Every match that I've had, I've gotten great compliments. I haven't had any negative feedback.
I enjoy the women's wrestling here more than the mainstream. Because you barely see the champion. Caitlin, she's champion, you barely saw her.
You see him wrestle.
At all.
What do? Slap each other around?
You have Mickey James now as champion. She's alright. She wrestled around Indy. She's from Best Professor.
Yeah.
We got Shimmer. We got the cheerleader. Do you watch any Shimmer or Shawn?
I do.
You do, yeah. Do you watch their Shimmer 53 the pay-per-view they had? That was good.
Yes, but I saw Lufisto get hurt.
I know, it's terrible. It hurt her up knee. When do you call the wrestlers retired? Calamity retired? A lot of them are retired.
Calamity's not retired.
No, but,
she is on, I do not say that.
Okay.
She's not retired.
Not
she's
retired.
Just on leave and doesn't know if she'll ever come back.
And you got Allison Danger leaving?
Allison Danger retired, that's not impressive. But she still trains.
Okay. And Yeah, he's come here to SoCal back to AWS July 20th. That'd be pretty cool.
Yeah.
You're not on that show, I guess.
Yes, I am.
You're on that show? Okay. It's supposed to be Mischief versus his Ray. And this Sunday will be Candice Ray versus Trudy Melissa. How do you think that match
will be? Oh my god, it's going to be amazing. Two amazing athletes. Candice Ray, cheerleader. Oh.
Would you want to be doing with Trudy Melissa? Maybe?
No, I've never wrestled her.
Never wrestled her?
I've never wrestled her. I would love to.
You wrestled in Mexico, didn't you?
No, I got injured on that trip.
Yeah, injured on that trip?
I am going to England soon.
Oh, yeah, I saw it. What was more details about England?
I can't tell you more.
I can't tell
about it until it gets closer to
what about all your tattoos? Can you tell me about all these? Man, how many do you got?
I have 157.
How long did that take? When did you first get your first tattoo?
18.
18?
I waited. You wait till you're 18. Legal age.
You can't ask how old you are now, because that's
you
ask.
I'm 22. I'll tell you, don't worry. I'm not like, oh my god, how old are you?
I'm 1 year older. 23.
So I don't have that many years to have all these.
So how long have you wrestled? You've been a newcomer about a year?
I will be in a year. I've been training for 2 years. I will be a year in front of a crowd July 7th.
And I'll say this. There's not a women's category, but I'll tweet it. Dashawns2cents, women rookie of the year right here. That's what I'm saying right here. That women's rookie of the year. I've been watching wrestling for a year now. Any wrestling, going to all the shows, you're the best woman I've seen. You and Candice LeRae, awesome. You've been in intensity, the heel factor, which is lacking in women's wrestling. Candice LeRae acting all...
What's this heel stuff?
Well, acting all... Okay.
Their hair slips around my hands, okay?
Yeah. Stuff happens. You can't
and
control it.
It falls out of my mouth. I can't control that.
And referees don't look. That's what happens. Referees don't see you. You can't call.
Yeah. Like tonight, I won cleanly against this woman. She just... messed up on that one.
I remember Trillium Lister. Who else do you want to be in the ring with?
Lufisto.
Oh, Lufisto, yeah.
Lufisto is who I am gunning for. I want a match with her so bad. The alpha female. She's in Japan right now, I think.
Okay. So is your goal Shimmer or Shine or WWE? What's your goal? I know everybody's goal is WWE and stuff.
My goal is Japan.
Japan? Yeah, that's what that's like a lot of people's goal.
I would love to work Shimmer and Shine. That's amazing for women, but I want to get out of the country. I want to be...
Japan. Yeah, I
want to be in Japan. I want to be in Europe. I want to be in Spain.
And travel the world. That's plenty of wrestlers can do is travel the world and see everything.
And you can learn so much.
Yes. A lot of good wrestlers have been Hamada, Toyota, a lot of good
wrestlers. She's another one I want to get in the ring with.
Chikara showcased a lot of them. It's too bad Chikara's gone. It's gone.
I never saw that.
It's gone. Yeah, I think it's an elaborate storyline, but it screws with the fans. You know, Sarah DeRay's not wrestling anymore. She's now a trainer.
Yes.
Have you seen Saturina wrestling? What do you think about her? She's like a luchadora. She jumps around. Sarah DeRay's like protege. Okay. So we're going to wrap this up. So what are your plugs? Twitter, Facebook? I know you just got on Twitter.
Oh, yeah. Twitter at Hudson Envy. Facebook, same thing.
Hashtag Team Envy all the time.
Hashtag Team Envy. Team Envy is what's new.
You got the shirt.
We got the future. Yes, we have the shirt.
Sure. The future of women's wrestling in SoCal right here.
Right here.
And the world, mostly. Yep. That's what's going to take over.
Slowly.
So yeah, thank you for being on.
Thanks for having me.
And make sure to like and continue.
I just want everybody to know there's a new sheriff in town and you're looking at it. I come here for one reason, and that is to attain the M1 championship belt, and I did that. Now I'm calling all the heels out. All you so-called bad heels, Snack Cakes, Rudy Poole, I'm calling you all out. Faces, come and stand with the chef. It's time for everyone to know that this is what we're supposed to be doing anyway. And I'm just calling all of you so-called bad rappers. Come on and let's see what the deal is. The chef ain't going to stir. Mm-hmm.